Number one, Crystal Eros at 45-1. Number two, Lady is a Pro, 30-1. A half sister to Town Pro, a two-time Breeders' Crown champion. Number three, Cammy's Lady at 20. Number four, Town Dreamer, a $7,000 bargain basement filly, 40-1. Number five, Immortality, with 11 wins in a row. The overwhelming public choice at 1-9, and Nuke's Magic completing the field at 25-1. Now we pick it up midway through the backstretch. Immortality made the lead rather easily around the first turn, taking the front from Cammy's Lady. She set moderate fractions to the half.
Marching for the far turn and for three quarters and coming after Immortality leads it by a length. Pressing her on the outside is Lady is a Pro. Cammy's Lady right there in the pocket. Nuke's Magic getting a good second over trip. Looks three wide for Bill Fay, and here she comes. Looking for room on the inside. Crystal Eros, then Town Dreamer. Immortality took them by three quarters in 1:26 and 2, a 29 second third quarter, and they turn for home. Immortality turns it on now. It's Immortality by 2-3, and she's drawing clear for Campbell with ease. Cammy's Lady full out in second. Nuke's Magic closing between horses. 12 in a row for the season's champion, Immortality and Campbell in 1:54 and 4.
Owned by Rose Guida and winning Verdict Stable. Another impressive performance by Immortality. She returned 210 and 210. Price is okay. Cammy's Lady 210 for the place. There was no show wagering. Time of the mile 1:54 and 4.
It is no surprise that John Campbell wins as a driver, or that a Guida owned horse wins this race. This is the third straight year. What is surprising is that a trainer can dominate the 2-year-old filly division like Bruce Nichols has. Five of the last eight champions in the 2-year-old filly division have been trained by Bruce Nichols, like Woody Stevens in the Belmont.
So No Nukes has his first champion in the Breeders' Crown. Immortality, first Cammy's Lady, Crystal Eros, Nuke's Magic, Town Dreamer, Lady is a Pro, the official order of finish.